This was and is still the inspiration and the drive and what gets me most excited. Why? Because it feels real. So here's what's gonna happen. I'm going to work on this board game that I've been working on and off for 4 years. It's called Fogbound. It's a pirate sailing exploration and fighting game, but there are many things missing yet, and I wanna bring you along on the journey, and I want your help in designing this board game to make it real. It's not Kickstarter ready yet, and it will be one day, but there's much work to be done. Let's build a board game together. My coffee. Yeah. This was my first game that I really started making, and it's had several iterations since the start of this idea. It originally was all started in this journal. All right, so imagine way back in the day, everyone has this conception that pirates, like from the Black Pearl and Pirates of the Caribbean, are these swashbuckling crazy people who go do crazy adventures and all that stuff. In actuality, it was kind of like that. But seriously, pirates back in the day were a lot more tame. They were more of merchants. They stole a lot of merchant vessel goods and went and traded them in port. Not all of them did these crazy adventures. Granted, to be truthful, the glamorized pirates are the ones we all love. This game is designed around the idea that you can be the pirate you want to be. All with this, where you start off with your ship, your captain, and you're given permission to hit the high seas and start attacking other vessels. Why isn't the game done yet, and why am I back here now on YouTube doing this type of stuff? Well, the truth is, this is all I have. I have all the pieces to the game that I once designed, and it was fully playable. But that's it, and this journal. Those are the things that exist currently now for this game and everything up here in my mind. I have not worked on this in 2 years, but it's time that it comes back. I'm gonna start plucking away at it, and we're gonna start with working from the notes and everything that I had for how the game is played. So I have grand visions for this game. I want to build a world around Fogbound, and I want Fogbound to be a small archipelago in the scheme of a bigger world and a bigger things going on and a bigger story, because every time you play this game, it's randomized. All right, so let me explain this to you so you guys kind of understand better what this game is supposed to be. So I'm gonna just do a really small version. Essentially, what you have is a world of tiles. You have ocean tiles and different things. This is supposed to represent a sandbar. There's islands and there's different nationalities. Like I said, this is gonna be changed. I want it to be its own world and own lore. But what happens is at the beginning of the game and you set up the tiles like this, in a much bigger world and a much bigger landscape. And then as you explore with your ships, you flip them over and you start to navigate this world. And eventually, with the right amount of players and the right amount of time, it happens within the first third of the game, the whole world's been flipped over, and then you can sail and traverse this world, visit islands, gather loot. So you can gather different loot from the islands and transport it with your ships. Each port will have a different market value, so you can trade that. You have to compete with other ships on the seas for the goods you have and the things that you've collected and relics that you've found as you're going to trade them. But the ultimate goal is to collect a bunch of these so you can upgrade your ship, to get a better ship, to get more cannons, to get more things, to get more cargo. And here's some other testing I've had of other different pieces of loot you can get. And ultimately, this is a player board example. Ultimately, you want to become the most notorious pirate on the seas, and the win condition is singular. The way to get there is many. So you choose how you play. Just like a role-playing game, you can customize your ship exactly how you want it, and you get to be the pirate you've always wanted to be and feel like an actual pirate role-playing. That's a pretty quick rundown And here's some more stuff. That's a pretty quick rundown of the game and what it's supposed to be. That allows you to explore a new world every time. But because of that, there has to be some explanation to why the world changes, why this archipelago changes every single time you go there. So every single game has a reason for it being different rather than replay value. I want it to have meaning to the game and to the players like you and I. So first thing we're gonna do is work on the world. I'm gonna work on the world and I'm gonna bring you guys on that, and I wanna share. To be truthful, I suck at naming things. In fact, so much that I suck, I have this thing called the Pirate Primer. It is, to my knowledge, the most extensive pirate dictionary. If you're interested in speaking like a pirate, this is literally the thing. Oh, look at that. I opened up to a page called Insult. It's all in here, Pirate Primer. So I'm using this to help give some flavor text and everything to my world. I do want it to be a pirate world, even though it's just one little piece of it. I want it to kind of all fit that theme. And I want there to be something like the Black Pearl or Pirates of the Caribbean in there, in terms of there's something beyond human. There's something in the fantasy realm that's embedded in this lore of the world. Once we get that going, we can start rebuilding the mechanics, and I can rebuild them and figure out what needs to go, and then start streamlining some of the processes that were kind of holding up this game in the past. Lastly is from playtesting and everything. Hold on a second. So it started off way like this. Started off with little paper cutouts that I made, and then I got these ones that I did up on Photoshop and then got them printed. These tiles, which they're nice. They're like a heavier cardboard type thing meant for board gaming. And then I moved on to wooden tiles. And I'll tell you what, there's nothing like holding and flipping over a wooden tile. And the same thing goes for the doubloons. There's nothing like having a real leather bag that you get the doubloons out of to make the game feel more real. But I want the game to feel authentic, and I don't want to sacrifice on anything. But I think the gameplay experience is hinged on those things. It's not just the mechanics that make the game great. I understand some people have a better imagination, but for me, I like to put on Pirates of the Caribbean music and play with the actual pieces when I do this, rather than paper cutouts or little cardboard chips for money value. First things first is rebuilding this game and picking it up back up from where I left off, and frankly, getting it back to where I left it off, because I lost a large document with a lot of instructions on it. So I'm gonna have to rebuild some of the mechanics. Then secondly, it's gonna be the world building, and that can be a mix of both as ideas come, and you guys can help out, pitch in, have ideas too. And then thirdly, is figuring out all the pieces, the artwork. I do a lot of my own artwork. I'm not by any means the most fantastic artist. I'm not a bad artist, but I'm going to try to attempt it myself. I know that costs can get really high for launching a game, and that's the ultimate goal. I don't have a timeline yet, but before next year this time, I hope that this game is to the point where a Kickstarter can be made and it can be launched to the public to try to get it made to what we want. And I want, like I said, to get you guys or whoever's watching involved and get everyone excited, and as many people as we can get to pitch in small ways. Like I said, names is gonna be a big thing. We can create this world and create this game and finally put it all together. And you can watch the difficulties of creating game mechanics and watching this happen live. And I can share it and enjoy it with the world even before it's out. So welcome to Fogbound, my friends. Let's build a board game together.